Sweden stands a tower of gray, harboring owls, eagles. Weathered by lightning, storm, and spray, a vestige of times medieval. Whatever life was once inside, that joy, that sorrow long since died. Horseman appears through the falling rain. He's spurring his stallion onward. Absorbed in thought, relaxed the reins. From the twilight path he's wandered. The forest howling, twisting wild, wind whipped as if a scolded child. It's said among the people here that at night within the tower, the walls aglow, a ghost appears with melancholy power. And who beholds his cursed gaze shall languish in fatal malaise. But without fear or worry's grip, through the gates of the horseman saunters. Cheerful and bold, he makes a grip, guiding his horse past the altar. Are we safer dry among the ghosts than in tempest gang soaked? The saddle and the sobbing bridle he unbuckles from his horse. Within the desolate chamber he idles, bedding draped upon the floor. After blessing the ancient hands, alas, who built a shelter so steadfast? The rider sleeps, the rider dreams, until at midnight hour, awakes his horse with snorts and screams. Inside a blazing tower, the walls burn in fiery bluster. The rider, aghast, his heart did muster. The horse's nostrils broadly flaring, baring teeth as if in pain. The stallion beholds a specter glaring, shivering from tail to mane. Sees the wicked guest and draws a cross about his breast. The ghastly monk before him steps, so awfully still, so doleful, as if through him the whole world wept. So woeful. Oh, so woeful. The horseman watches mesmerized, with sadness, pity, paralyzed. That vast and secret hidden grief that through all nature resonates, that a bleeding heart may perceive, that misery penetrates but never attains, that pain appears in the monk's eyes. The rider tears. What haunts you so? Please tell, he cries. What caused you such despair? But as the spectre drops his eyes, his pale lips part, prepare to share his monstrous tale of woe. The horseman shouts, please no! Please no! Into the lake.